Welcome to the Kenny Hack. Hello and thanks for watching. For this tutorial, we're going to be going over how to do the Norton method, which is the white paint on white tile or ceramic. In this case, this is a plate I got at the dollar store, and it's probably the first try I've really done with the Norton method. It was always such a slow method. I just really never thought about giving it a try, but I didn't have any other big projects lined up for today, so I thought I'd finally give it a try. Now, the first thing you want to do to prep these plates is to give them a good cleaning with acetone or paint thinner and just get that clear coat film kind of off of it. So I sat here with some acetone, just poured a little on the plate and washed it off for like about 5 minutes or a couple minutes till I thought it was good and clean. Then I kind of gave it a quick blow dry just to make sure all the acetone is dry. And you can see I'm using the Rust-Oleum 2X flat white. Now for the painting, I just kind of do a slow, steady 50% overlap on the first pass, just trying to get a good, even first coat. Now for the next two passes, I rotate the plate about 45 degrees, and I'm just giving it just a really quick over, trying to still kind of keep it even, but I'm just kind of trying to make sure I didn't leave any little gaps somewhere in the paint. So I did that for one coat, rotated another 45 degrees, and gave it another quick hit. After the second coat, I power dried it for about 5 to 10 minutes to make sure the paint was good and dry, and then I went straight to burning it. I didn't let it dry overnight. So the first thing we're going to do is create our template for the plate design. Now this is just going to be a bunch of series of rings kind of used to outline the projects and the different parts of it. The first layer will be the very outside edge of the plate, the full plate diameter. And for my plates that I have, that is 264 millimeters. So you unlock it, go 264, 264. And then we'll grab that, move it pretty close to into the center of our work area. Try to line it up right on one of the grid lines so it's easy to find the center spot. Now the next ring is going to be for the outer ring, where if you want to put text out on the outer edge, that's what these next two rings are for. They're going to be 225 millimeters, and we'll set that as a new layer. And 225. So now we grab that one, and we're going to add a text layer to that. I'm just put in text here. This is your template, so you're just going to access that later, and you can change the text to whatever style or size that you want at a later date. We're going to grab that, and hold shift and highlight both of them together. And then you want to apply path to text once they're both highlighted. And it always snaps it over here to the left and orientates it to this direction. Now we're going to want that at the top of our plate. So let's rotate that 90 degrees. Now we're going to draw in another ring. Going to be another 225 by 225. We're just going to go ahead and apply another text here. We're going to hold shift
highlight both of them. And then we're going to, once again, go to Tools, Apply Path to Text. But this one's going to be on the bottom, but we want to maintain the orientation that it's you're reading it right side up. So to do that, flip it the other way around and just redo. There might be another way to do that, but that's just the easiest way I've found to do this. So now it's tilted the other way. And then we'll rotate that to the 90. Let's go ahead and get that back to 225. Okay, so now we have both of our rings set to 225 for our text. Now we're going to create an inner ring. And this is where like your image is going to go. And get a circle in there. Let's move that to another layer. Make that one green. Let's turn all these on so they're easier to see. And this one here, like I make all my images like 6-inch diameter, and that is 152.4 millimeters. So to kind of like, and when the image gets burned in, if you're doing a full image, it can get kind of pixelated along the outside edge. You can kind of see like every pass where your line spacing is. So to kind of mask that, I put in a little ring around the out over the top of the edge. So we're going to do one ring at 152 millimeters. And then we'll do another ring. And this one here will be 153. So it's only a half millimeter wide ring, but it does a really good job of masking that outer edge of the image and kind of frames it all in. So right there, you're going to want to save that as your template. So you go to Save, Save As. And I got a little plate file just for nothing but plates. We're going to save that as plate template. I'll call this one number 2. I already have one made up, but I was doing this for the video. And so right there, that's basically what you're going to use for all your future plates if you stick with the same plate design. And you can always modify this here and there. One thing I found is you want your text on the one piece I did about 30 millimeters is about a thick of text as you want to go. I think if you went much bigger than that, it's going to start getting really out of focus on the outer edge. It depends on how flat your plate is. Mine was pretty tapered. It had from at 30 height on the text. From the inner edge to the outer edge had almost 6 millimeters of difference. So you're trying to burn across 6 millimeters of variation. And that's a lot of focus range. It burned it really good in the middle 50%, but the outer 25% edges was starting to get pretty faded. And after I acetone cleaned, it started kind of disappearing. So that's probably as big as you want to go. So let's open up GIMP. I already opened up that image in there, and I already edited this image on my phone. I turned it into a circle and deleted out the edges to turn it into a PNG file. You don't want your laser burning anything outside that circle. From there, I just went to scale image, did my usual, except for now that I'm not using grayscale, I'm going to be using newsprint. I'm going to do my double DPI trick that I use on a lot of, anytime I'm using the dither modes, is I double the DPI in GIMP and I'll cut it in half in Lightburn. It just helps make a finer image. So I set it to 636 and 6 inches in diameter. Hit scale. From there, I just export as, and I saved it with the saying that it was a 6 inch round, 636 DPI in a PNG file. And I hit export, but I don't really need to do that. I already got it saved. So from there, let's jump over to Lightburn and look at how we set up this project using the plate template. And so here is the project that we're looking at. I'll turn on all the layers. So we had our outer ring, and that's, you can use the shift frame and use this frame one that has a circle on it, and the laser will follow that outer ring if it's highlighted and set to frame it. And then you can line your plate up using that. It should draw right around the outside edge of the plate all the way around. And then you'll know all your everything else should line up pretty well centered on your plate. And from there, I just imported the image. We went over in GIMP, snapped it into the center of this one. You can use, got the updated Lightburn. So you can, if you right click on it and go to adjust image, it brings up the side-by-side comparison. Here's the original, here's after I adjusted it. I kind of use my typical settings I do on a lot of projects that I don't just kind of starting off with. I adjusted the contrast. Normally I go down to negative 15. I went down to negative 12, brought the brightness up to 10. I raised, didn't have the gamma at 3. Had it at, sorry, computer's kind of locking up here. Now I can't seem to get it to 1.35. Like, I really don't need the side-by-side. If you're more comfortable, just go to shape properties. And it seems a little easier to use in here. I ran this one at a negative 1.35. I don't know why this thing is not cooperating here. I'll just type it in. I ran at 1.35, negative 12 contrast, 10 on the brightness, went to 30 enhancement radius, and enhancement amount 100%. It kind of just makes the brighter, the blacks and whites pop a little bit more. And from there, my settings on the image, I didn't run any practice tests on this. I've seen enough posts in the forums that I just took a best stab at it and what I typically see. So I just set it to run at 1,000 millimeters per minute, 85% power, and 318 DPI. And I run on the 90 degree scan angle, and I used newsprint. Now, as I showed you in GIMP, I set the DPI to 636. It's a trick I use on wood and canvas when I was using my 20 watt. Anytime I'm using the dithers, I will double the DPI in GIMP and cut it in half in Lightburn. It just seems to help make a finer dot matrix when using the newsprint. Otherwise, these dots can get pretty big. And I think when it's initially brought in with such a high DPI, it makes these dots a lot smaller and just makes for a smoother image. I mean, if you get really close to the image, you can kind of see the dot matrix a little bit, but if you're viewing it from a couple feet away, you can't see them. So that was my settings for the image. The next part, might have a little continuity problem here. I had to stop my first recording and start over. So for the second, for the blue ring, the settings on that one, still 1,000 millimeter speed, 85% power. You need the two rings so it'll fill between them. And you put it on an offset fill so it'll fill in a circular pattern. That really cuts down the time. This one only will take like 3.5 minutes. And then for the outer text, those are all set to fill. Since they're on that sloped edge of the plate, that's about 6 millimeters difference from the high edge to the low edge, I ran this even slower. I ran it down to 700, hoping that that slower speed would kind of allow it to burn more out of focus and still get the paint to fuse in. And it seemed to work pretty good. It got a little faded on the edge, but for a wanted poster looking image, I didn't mind that it faded out on that edge. Might not work for every use. If you're making a wedding plate or something, you just have to tell the clients that it's kind of unavoidable, you know, unless they would go to really small text that can stay inside the focus range. Like I said, stayed on 85% power, 318 dpi, and 90 degrees, field groups together. And we'll kind of go jump through and show how long each of these burns takes. After 4 or 5 months of not going below 6,000 millimeters per minute, it was pretty tough for me to sit here and watch this 1,000 millimeters per minute speed, but didn't really have any other projects I was working on, so I thought I'd finally get onto this Norton method and give it a try. So, we don't need... turn all these other ones off. So that one took about 3 hours and 50 minutes, pretty close to what it really took to burn this blue ring. It only took about 3.5 minutes. And then to do the text, it took about 45 minutes. So all the times were pretty close to what it predicted. And you can see it was just filling each letter at a time. It wasn't wasting time trying to go from the bottom clear up to the top. It was just doing each one, and that saved a lot of time. If it was trying to go from one area to the other, it would have taken it hours to scan across the plate, even with the fast scan on. So all in all, that project took about 4.5 hours. I didn't really capture any video of it. It's too slow to be of much interest on how fast it goes, and it's a speed everybody knows these things run at, so I don't really have to prove I'm running as fast as what I say I am. We'll jump over, we'll kind of take a close-in look at how the burn turned out, look at the finer details, and see what it looks like.
One thing to keep in mind is the order in which you burn. The image and the little ring around it all has to be burned at the same time, and you'll focus onto the center of the plate depth. For the outer ring, I focused on about the center of the text to get it the widest range of focus and to get it the darkest burn on the text. Here's the final image after I acetone cleaned it. And I cleaned it off pretty much the same way I cleaned it off at the start of the video. Just poured a little acetone onto the surface. Had a bunch of paper towels on hand to just keep wiping all the excess paint off until you're not picking up any more paint and you're not picking up any black residue left over from the burn. Here's a little better close-up of the details of the burn. You can see the edges are a little bit faded, like I said, but overall turned out pretty good for my first try. Pretty happy with how it turned out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.